Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to the channel. Now today we are going to be reviewing the Yeezy 700 V2 cream, so let's get straight into it. All right, so here we have it. It comes in your regular Yeezy 700 V2 box. Now one thing that I am a little bit worried about is the actual sizing of this sneaker. So basically what happened is I bought these sneakers from Offspring, and if you guys are used to entering Offspring raffles, you would know that they only give you like 2 or 3 minutes to enter. And so in the heat of the moment, you know, I was just reading through the instructions, because they give you like a different set of instructions for each raffle even though it's like 2 or 3 minutes. So I was so focused on getting like the keywords right that I completely forgot that I'm supposed to go half a size up in terms of sizing for Yeezys. So I did pick these up in a size UK 8, which is a US 8.5, but I am a bit worried about the sizing. I'm scared that it is gonna fit a little bit on the tight side, but I don't know, we'll see when we get to the sizing section of this video. If you do wanna know about the sizing, definitely make sure to stick around till the end of the video. But yeah, I would like to remind you guys that I am currently holding a 5,000 subscriber giveaway, where the winner could win either a pair of the Puma Cali sneakers or a sneaker gift voucher. All you need to do in order to enter this giveaway is to subscribe and comment down below your favorite sneaker followed by your Instagram handle so that I can contact you if you win. And that's it, you'll be entered in for the raffle. I will draw the winner on the 20th of April, so yeah, good luck to anyone that enters. But anyways, let's take a look at the Yeezy 700 V2 cream. Here we have it, just your regular Yeezy 700 box. They never like decide to switch up the boxes like Jordan brand, it's always your regular brown box. Now one thing I would say is that the sneakers actually came with a brown tag. I did take it off, but it came with like this paper brown tag as opposed to the usual plastic tag that we get. You know, the Yeezy brand have gotten rid of some of the plastic details, making it a bit more eco-friendly, which is always like what we like to see in sneakers. But anyways, yeah. Now another thing that I would like to mention is that these sneakers actually retailed at £210. You know, these have gone down by £40, which is actually quite a lot. I am really happy that they brought down the retail, because £250 for a pair of sneakers, I think they were pushing the boundaries a little bit. And you know, £210 is still quite high, but the fact that they brought it down is quite impressive. But anyways, okay, let's take a closer look at these sneakers. So starting from the sole of the shoe, it comes in this off-white kind of cream colorway that has a wave pattern running across the midsole of the sneaker. Moving down to the actual sole of the shoe, we have this black sole with varying geometric patterns and the usual foam that you would also see on your 350 design. And one thing I would say about the sole is that it's not really like a solid black, it's more of a grayish kind of black tint. Okay, so for the actual body of this sneaker, we have a lot of different materials, I can say that. So we have this kind of like brown tan colored leather. I want to say kind of a more of a peach tint of brown for the other leather that is also used for the eyelets of the sneaker. Then we have a grey textile material, which is really nice and soft to the touch. And we also have this 3M reflective stripes that, depending on how the light shines on it, it will become reflective, or if you use a flash to take a picture, they will also become reflective, which I think is a really nice detail. I don't know if a lot of people are a big fan of it, but honestly, I really like it. Now, in terms of laces, we have just regular grey laces, the same colour as the tongue. And for the inside of the sneaker, the inside comes in a light grey lining with your Yeezy and Adidas logo in a slightly darker grey colour. So yeah, that is basically all that is going on with this sneaker. It doesn't really feature that much Adidas Yeezy branding on the outside. The only branding that we do have on this sneaker is the Adidas logo on the sole, and then the Adidas Yeezy logo on the inside, and obviously on the box as well. That's all the branding that you do get on the sneaker. Overall, I do think it's a really nice, clean, slick design. So yeah, this is definitely a good option if you wanted to go ahead and buy a pair of the Yeezy 700s. Now, let's try them on. Thank you. Okay, so after trying them on, I can confirm that my fears were true. So basically, it does fit a little bit on the tight side. I think if I was to keep this sneaker in the future, I would definitely need to trade this one for one that is half a size up. It's just small details like that. And I think, you know, when spending such a high amount of money on a sneaker, you definitely want to get the sizing right so that anytime you wear it, you know, it feels really comfortable on the foot. So yeah, it is a little bit on the tight side, so I would definitely say if you are buying this sneaker, go half a size up, especially if you have slightly wider feet. But yeah, there we have it, the Yeezy 700 V2 Cream. What are your opinions on this sneaker? Definitely comment down below. And also, if you do want to see how I styled this sneaker, don't forget to head over to my sneaker Instagram at VAO_sneakers. But yeah, that's the end of the video, and see you in the next video.